Hey everyone, it's Riggs, and we're back with another Indiana Jones video. It's been a little over a week since James Mangold's last pushback, let's say, on the leaks and spoilers and speculation that have been flying around the internet, most notably, I think, being pushed by YouTuber Doomcock. And I don't think he's ever going to be able to get past this until this movie comes out and either he's proven to be right or shown to be a liar. Here we have, from a day ago, CBR.com, yet another article that looks to be kind of speculating about the same sort of stuff. I'll put the link to the article in the description to the video. Indiana Jones 5 looks like another attempt to pass the torch. The trailer for Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny has arrived, and it looks like another attempt to pass the torch or whip to a new character. The first look at Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny has finally arrived, and it's already garnering elated reactions from fans. The trailer is chock full of Easter eggs and callbacks, but some of the most exciting moments speak to the future. To be more specific, certain elements point towards a new beginning for the storied adventure series, with the introduction of Phoebe Waller-Bridge's character Helena, and the trailer's focus on wistful looks back on Indiana Jones' history. Dial of Destiny seems like another attempt to pass the torch. So this is what I think the meltdown from James Mangold has been about, calling everybody a-hole trolls and whatnot. It makes sense from a strategic standpoint for Disney to take a newer, hipper, younger character and make more quote-unquote Indiana Jones content with it. With that character in the future, whether or not it's a ceremonial handing of the baton or an actual reboot that casts Helena as a replacement for Indiana Jones, who knows? But it seems to make sense. With Harrison Ford aging out of his iconic role, despite the use of de-aging technology, it feels like the right time for the end of Indy's adventures at long last. At long last, we've only had like five good ones. Not five good ones, four ones and three good ones. But given the current state of the cinematic world, it's a foolhardy proposition to believe that any franchise with the earning potential of one Indiana Jones could ever reach a true finale. With that in mind, it's a near certainty that groundwork is being laid in Dial of Destiny for a continuation. Phoebe Waller-Bridge could be the next in line for the Indiana Jones role. Oh, boy. I can't wait till James Mangold gets a wind of this article and this video. I see you, James. One of the primary pieces of evidence pointing to a continuation is the introduction of Helena. Indy refers to him as her godfather, and she looks like an essential element of the plot. Most key set pieces teased in the recently released trailer involve Helena directly. In fact, in one quick moment, she even dons similar garb to Indy's iconic adventure outfit. The trailer emphasizes the end of the Indiana Jones era. The trailer emphasizes Dial of Destiny being the iconic character's last ride. The tone is wistful and backward-facing, bringing back characters not seen since the original trilogy, like Jonathan Rhys Davies Sala, and Sala's voiceover narration reminiscing over the pair's previous adventures, combined with Harrison Ford's age, implies that this picture is the one in which Indy finally hangs up his hat. Additionally, the trailer promises the franchise return of the series' ultimate big bad, Nazis. All the iconic elements of the original Indiana Jones trilogy are back in full force, which speaks to the last hurrah energy of the proceedings on display in the trailer. Indiana Jones already tried to pass the torch before. There's also a precedent set in the Indiana Jones franchise for attempted torch passing. In the previous installment, Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, Indy's illegitimate son, Mutt Williams, portrayed by then It Boy, Shia LaBeouf, appeared to be getting primed to take on the adventurer mantle in his father's stead. The film's final shot even featured Mutt literally picking up his pop's iconic fedora in a clear wink towards the character's potential future. Due to poor reception, that future never materialized. Clearly, though, the intent is there. While Waller-Bridge's character likely won't function as a literal replacement for Indiana Jones, Under this path, the next step in the franchise wouldn't be an Indiana Jones film. It would be a Helena-centric spinoff, with the character's own adventures front and center. I'm not even sure that would be true. We've got this thought that Indiana Jones could be basically wiped out of existence, and Helena having to step into his shoes, literally, and do all the classic stuff that the character had done in order to avoid breaking the universe or causing some kind of Back to the Futures type paradox where Donald Trump is president. Wait a minute. Never mind. Plot details surrounding Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny are scarce, to say the least. Theories abound that time travel plays some part in Indy's newest adventure, and it totally does. I don't know why anyone's even like pretending it doesn't at this point, which opens up an entirely different can of worms in terms of franchise implications. But as the trailer clearly displays, Indiana Jones as a character is nearing his cinematic end. And more importantly, the hints peppered throughout the same trailer indicate that when an inevitable sequel arrives, it will have Phoebe Waller-Bridge's character Helena as the headliner. Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny debuts in theaters June 2023. I don't know if it's going to be a sequel movie, probably a TV show. We've talked about it before. They're laying the groundwork for a Disney Plus TV show. It's going to be a Helena-centered show. Anyway, James Mangold, I'm sure, will be thrilled to see that people are still talking about this. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell for notifications. If you wouldn't mind giving the video a like, it really helps put some more eyes on it. If you enjoyed the content, please share the video with your friends and online acquaintances, and it'll really help the channel grow. Thanks a lot, and we'll see you next time.